Hello, my name is Jean, and welcome to InspireYouthful.com, where I share the art of ageless living. Today, I'm doing the first part of a four-part series for youthful movement, focusing on legs and core and handstands. So let's have some fun. Don't forget, if you're not feeling well, don't do the workout. And if this is new moves for you and you've never done anything like this, take it easy. And always talk to your doctor to see if this kind of exercise is good for you. Let's have some fun. Check the blog post that goes with this video for the exact workout. Let's begin with the warm-up with our wrists into shaking out our arms and then shoulder circles back and then shoulder circles forward. Let's warm up our neck, bend our head side to side, and then turn our head right and left. Next, let's do our arm swings. This opens up the chest and shoulders. Into our side bends. And then our cross toe touches. Try to keep your back flat as you reach across to your toe. Then our knee ups, pull your knee to your chest. And then hip circles. Other way. Into our deep resting squat. So this squat is a restful position, though it can be hard. If you can't sustain this squat, hold on to the wall or to a chair so that you can, you know, sit down as low as you can. Your feet should be flat on the ground and bring your butt as close to the ground as you can. Your back should feel nice and relaxed and your knees out and wide. So your toes are turned out and your knees are turned out. Try to keep your shoulders down and your chest open and stay looking straight ahead. Moving into our panther crawl, extend one leg out to the side and support your upper body with your hands. As you switch from side to side, pass through the deep squatted pose. This movement should be done nice and easy. In later videos, we'll be building upon this movement. So definitely try to do this movement a few times this week so you get the hang of it. It should feel easy. You're just moving from side to side and you're supporting yourself on the floor. Moving into our quadruped contralateral reach. So extend the opposite arm and opposite leg out and then bring them together. You can do this for time or reps. On the video, I'm doing them for at least 30 seconds on each side. Try to keep your shoulders locked down away from your ears. And exhale as you draw the arm and leg together, drawing in the stomach. Switch sides and pass through that seated squat again. And doing the other side, same thing, keep the shoulders locked back. Exhale as you draw the arm and leg together. Keep your head in line with your spine. Don't let it drop as you're looking to the floor. So keep your head lifted. This is a great workout for your total core. Into our supported back bends. Moving from right to left, support your back and then extend the opposite arm back and look back. Go as far back as you are able to go and just fluidly move from side to side. Do this for 30 seconds or for reps. Moving into our cat and cow. Get in quadruped position. Keep your shoulders locked back and round your spine, dropping your head, looking at your belly button, and then arching your back and looking up towards the ceiling. Exhale as you round the back, drawing in the stomach. Into our plank hold. On the video, I'm holding the plank for 30 seconds. You can do 30 seconds or shorter. You can also do your plank on your knees. Keep your shoulders locked back, your stomach pulled in, and your head aligned with your spine. Moving into our torso twists. From plank position, twist up and look up and alternate sides. Try to keep your shoulders packed into their shoulder joints. Exhale as you look up, passing through plank in the middle. You can also do this on your knees. Here I am showing on the knees. I'm still nursing my wrist injury, so you could see there that I'm knuckling up on my right hand. And that just gives me added support. Into our kneeling march. Make sure you have a yoga mat or a Pilates pad when you're doing this, or you're doing it on rug so you're protecting your knees. This move is fairly simple and we'll be building upon it in the next set of videos, but it's still a challenge and it's very functional because this is how you would potentially get up after kneeling on the floor without your hands, of course. You can do this for time or for reps, doing what feels right for you. Moving on to our lunge kickbacks. So get in runner stance and just lift the back leg up, kicking back and straightening the front leg. This is done for 30 seconds on each leg. Try to keep your back flat and try not to round it too much. Moving Moving on to our wrist stretches in prayer hands and pressing down on the wrist and then pressing back on the wrist. I've definitely gone to appreciate my wrist stretching exercises. They've really helped strengthen my wrists. And here I am leaning forward, putting pressure on my wrists, and then my hands, laying the back of my hands, applying pressure. And just enough pressure that feels good, nothing that feels painful. And then bringing my hands backwards. And giving it a good shake. All right, moving into our L stance. Crawl up on the wall, find your L shape, holding L shape for 30 seconds. Push your shoulders back away from your ears. Make sure your abs are drawn in. Your gaze is on the floor at your fingertips. So this is the way I've been teaching myself how to do a handstand. I'm not great at it, but I've definitely improved. At 40 years old, I did my first handstand, and that was just a few months ago. So it's never too late to learn. This pose is called 135 because it's the angle of which your leg is going. Again, lock your shoulders back away from your ears. Your gaze is to the floor in between your hands. Your stomach is pulled in. And you try to bring your butt over your shoulders and hold for as long as you are able. Next, we'll be moving on to the kick-ups. And of course, each person has quote-unquote one good leg, and of course, that's my right leg. So as you see my right leg doing it, it looks nice and smooth. I land gently on the wall. And then my left leg comes and bangs on the wall. But, you know, what are you gonna do? You don't give up, you just keep practicing. And it's good to practice both sides because that's how you're gonna even out the strength and flexibility and coordination. See that? That was a bang. But don't give up. And then after the kick-ups, I'm going to do two or three handstands against the wall. When I do my handstand practice, I generally only do a few handstands at a time, like at the most five or six, so that I don't overdo it on my wrists and shoulders. I know that I have a lifetime to get good at handstands and inversions. There's really no point in trying to force my body into anything that will, you know, potentially injure me or make me feel any aches and pains. I hope you enjoyed that video. Again, this is just the first video of a series of four. We'll be building on top of the exercises we learned today, and I hope you join me for those other videos. My name is Jean. Thank you so much for joining me. Visit me at inspireyouthful.com, where I share the art of ageless living.